There are those who say the time of myth and legends is long past. Thanks to things like being able to record any moment at any time with a cell phone, keeping records of proof is easier than ever. Places like Facebook and YouTube make it very simple to share and store these moments in order as what has been called a perfect memory. Well, the internet may be forever, but it is definitely not perfect. Archives and websites go down. Anti-bot scripts can lock out the Wayback Machine. People edit their memories of programs and filters to be what they wanted them to be long before they ever upload them. Perspectives color what is written and sent from both the writer and reader's sides. It is not all black and white. If the internet provides a place for a perfect record, why do we keep changing things? The truth is that we as a species still need mythic heroes and legends. We like to feel we have control in our lives and that we are powerful. We need to hear about the chosen ones and to experience a little bit of glory in our lives. If we didn't have these mythic figures and moments, the crushing fate of death and our overall powerlessness in the face of the universe would be overwhelming. The problem is that legends only really work for those who can connect with them. Old standbys like Hercules are fading out because it's a lot harder for a modern person to connect to an ancient Greek figure attached to gods they themselves aren't connected to. In light of this, we create new heroes and legends constantly. Generally, legends come in two types, nostalgia goggles and never was. The nostalgia goggles version happens to everyone and creates personalized myths. As long as we as a species can form fond memories, we will keep expanding on the fondness of those memories. This turns a so-so cartoon into the best thing from your childhood and a 5-inch fish into a whopper. Sure, you can go on Facebook and see the 5-inch fish or rewatch the cartoon and see it was merely passable, but most people aren't likely to do this because doing so would shatter the glory. It would break the myth, leaving you with nothing. We all know this subconsciously, which is why I suspect the backfire effect exists. There are entire videos on the backfire effect, so I'll keep this brief. The backfire effect, in a nutshell, says that when something contradicts a deeply held belief, we aren't likely to accept it. Nostalgia is usually a deeply held belief that something or someone is great. We can see the fish was small, and the cartoon was just okay, but are likely to never really accept it deep inside, as that small voice will always say they were great. Sometimes nostalgia goggles aren't enough. In these cases, we start to look up to those people and events we know are imaginary. I would like to propose that more popular modern imaginary figures are on par with classical mythological figures. Both modern and classical characters have shared stories to entrench them in our minds. They perform amazing feats of greatness. They can be flawed, tragic, or just plain heroic. Some people even believe they were or are real. Look up Fictionkin for the tip of the iceberg. Either way, they are something shining, calling out to us. This is why they last. Not every imaginary character or event fits this mold. Some are too flawed, some are too shallow, some just don't strike a chord with people. But enough are sticking that they are creating a cultural impression that changes people. The exploits of Ash Ketchum or Deadpool are more well-known in some circles than the exploits of Hercules. As explained in the famous Is There a Santa Claus editorial, it doesn't matter if they are real or not. What matters is how your perception of the character or event colors your perspective and changes your behavior. You embrace the good in them, and you strive to be good too. And those who are still frightened and lost? A lot of the time, instead of creating and embracing heroes, they created and embraced villains. They look at a group or a figure which may or may not have ever existed and embrace the evil. They soon see bad everywhere and feel powerless, lost, and alone. Identity crises and irrational fears begin to set in. They grew up being told someone will save them but don't see anyone coming to save them. They become frightened and want a hero. Some people decide to become a hero. This can take many forms, from those who genuinely do good in their community, to people making idiots out of themselves on the internet as they seek enough validation from others to finally feel like a hero. This search for a hero also allows charismatic figures to be able to lead mobs and terrorist groups. Most people try to get through to the frightened ones by spewing facts in an attempt to break the myth of the evil one. This is not likely to work thanks to the backfire effect. The frightened ones must find myths of hope to replace and overcome their myths of fear. The change has to come from inside, often led by example, or it just won't come. As you can see, modern myths and legends are everywhere and are still very powerful in our lives. I haven't gone out of my way to name many examples, but I'm sure a few have come to your mind already. Feel free to leave some modern legends in the comments or fire back with your thoughts on the subject. Thank you very much for listening.